Hey guys, back again with KOA in a chat. Today we are going to go find the fisherman's bride, who is a nymph, apparently. She went missing, and yeah, I don't see this ending well for him for some reason. Oh, look. Well, there's a new thing we haven't seen yet. Oh, look, and we've got to go up here. Like I said in the last episode, I will be telling more sort of, oh gosh, I don't know whether I'm ready for that. Can I creep past you? I'm supposed to kill them though, aren't I? Oh shivers, he runs! Okay, good thing I saved up that. Oh, X. Okay. Wow.
There she is.
Hello.
My lovely bride.
Don't speak up on me.
I am all dressed and prepared for our wedding. Thank you, stranger.
You look very nice.
Bless you. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to seal my bond with a ring and a kiss. Any last words for a crusty bachelor?
Good luck to you.
My nymph! She just felt that disgusting etching with a glance. Beauty cures even the beast, so they say. Did you not see her wiggle away to the cliff overlooking the lake? It's where we first met, you know. A grand spot for our union. Well, friend, if there's nothing else, I'm off. You're welcome to witness the event if you care to. Wait a moment. That's no nymph. That's not the graceful creature I fell in love with. You were good enough to go along with an old man's wishes. Might I ask one more of you? I want you to kill that beast to preserve the memory of my bride.
I'll
see you rewarded if you do.
I just did.
You've seen the chaos and destruction the thing has caused. It's a
Didn't
demon of the
cut?
Waters. Not only that, but to think I ever loved that thing. It's shameful. Please. It burdens my old heart. I'll reward you for the work. I promise you that much. Just see it gone.
Okay.
Farewell.
Oh, you mean that thing? That's what you fell in love with? You need glasses, friend? Okay. Well, I did tell you that I was going to continue with the spooky stories. Hi there. Wow, magic doesn't serve them well, does it? Boots of anti-venom. Why not? No, I don't want to add it to junk. Horrified gasp. Yeah, that one. Yeah, remove from junk. Thank you. I need them. Cotton robes. Why aren't I wearing these? Ooh. Look at you all fancy. Sturdy armor. May as well add that to junk. Gloves of skill. Cotton gloves. Yeah, let's take these. Oh, I can't. Oh, that's why I'm not wearing them. Okay, steady gauntlets. Yeah, hang on. They can be repaired though, so I might keep them. Oh, the robes don't require the leggings, I don't think. Oh, hello. Okay. Let's put some clothes on. Might be a good idea. Sturdy shoes. Yeah, let's equip that. Alright then. There we go. Let me go. Whoa. Oh my gosh, look at that. Ah, the enemies are getting huge.
So brief his term among our court. So virile in his living.
He is
revered and embodied.
Must...
That's the end of that, then. Oh. Sorry for roping you into such a task, stranger. It's just, you see enough sadness in your life, and you see chances for happiness wherever you look. Now for your reward. Take my wedding ring. Based on Imelda's memory long enough, seems fair I give up what hasn't been taken. It ain't much. Just a small charm that she had when we were wed. When fever took her, I mounted it on her grave. And then one of those two-headed bastards pried it off, carried it to the lake, giggling like a pair of fools. Wouldn't dare follow the beasts there. But if you... well, you've helped me enough.
I'll get it for you, buddy.
Thank you. You're a kind soul indeed.
He's just lonely.
He ate and took to the shore as soon as I saw him. He's somewhere on the lake's edge, I'm sure of it. One of those Etin took it and headed south, along the shore. He's somewhere on this lake. I know that much.
Alright, I can definitely help you. Poor old thing. Okay. I don't think we can actually fast travel there. Okay, so let's continue to help out this old guy, poor thing. So I need to get down there. I hate that you can't jump and climb like you can in Skyrim. That is my one complaint about this game. Wait a second, isn't this... linen. Huh. Okay, I'm guessing that you're one of the ones that I want. This is gonna be interesting. Let's see Tabby die. Okay, so another spooky story. Another weird thing that's happened. I've been to a couple of places on sort of ghost hunting or... just through the day as like a tourist. I went to a place called Monte Cristo. Hang on. Ooh, interesting. 36, and that's 42. Interesting. I really do like those though. So let's just stick with that for now. Yeah, so there's this place in a little country town called Junee in New South Wales, Australia. It's kind of in the middle of nowhere. But it is the location of Australia's most haunted residential homestead. Hi, don't chase me, please. Are you serious? Now it's telling me to go back up? Make up your mind. Where am I supposed to be going? I don't want to go somewhere and have to fight these big ugly guys without needing to. Yeah, and it's supposedly, it's got a really dark history. Nannies throwing children downstairs, and there was a disabled person that was chained up outside in the barn. And I don't know what happened, whether he was set on fire or he set himself on fire, but yeah, something like that happened. And there've been sort of all these weird things that have happened. Some people in the town don't even like visiting the place because they feel like it's cursed or something. And it does genuinely have a creepy feel. Like, it's, the house was burnt down and sort of gutted by vandals at one point because it was let go. Where am I supposed to be going here? Alright, let me have a look at this map. Alright, I have to follow the path sort of this way, I guess. Um, Oh, okay, I see. I do have to go past there. Okay. I see. Yeah, and it's a fascinating place to visit, whether you are into paranormal stuff or you just like architecture and restored old buildings, because it is quite nice what they've done to the place. I haven't been there in a number of years, but when I went, it was quite nice. One of the rooms they actually recarpeted with carpet that was used in something to do with the Beatles. Don't know, it was studio from carpet from their studio or something. I'm really doing well with the memory today, aren't I? Hello there. Oh, I don't like how these guys run at me. Oh wow, he has something that's big and not helpful to me at all. Holy crap! I think we need to go back to somewhere and restock on health and everything. Yeah, so basically, there have been sightings of the previous owners who were named the Crawleys, ironically enough. Go Hut Inn, is that where I want to be going? Or wait, let me figure out where I'm going. Corner shop, yeah, that'll do. Why not? Apparently,
Come
Mr.
in.
Crawley was being seen wandering around, and Mrs. Crawley, who was known as this sort of
Come in. Come in. You
iron
wouldn't believe how busy we've been
tell
since
me to
that
come
fae
in, I'm in.
arrived.
Rose of Longbow. I really need Iron Hammer. That's no good to me, really. Oh yeah, sell all the junk. Whatever I've got, you can have. Wait, I don't need that. I'm looking for repair kits. Oh, hello. Damn, I could have used that. I find those. Oh, dang. I need
Come see me again.
repair kits, really. Who are you? Nobody of interest. Wait, do you sell repair kits? No. Let me talk to her.
What do you need?
Repair kit. Oh, okay, yeah, just repair everything, please. There we go.
I'll be here.
Okay. Cool.
Welcome to Gorehart.
Thank you very much. I'll be going now. Hello,
I
Nanny.
don't know if I'll ever take on another apprentice, not after Karth's betrayal. It just
Poor
goes to
little
show
thing.
that we gnomes should stay with our own.
No, you can't let one. Actually, no, that's too much money to be spending on that. Yeah, definitely.
Farewell.
Hello there.
Hello, you're so friendly. Nice to meet somebody who's friendly. Not telling me to go away. Can I? Awesome. Need as many of these as possible. There we go. Okay, let's go. Wait. Can't
What
get
do
out
you
that
want?
way. Okay, I take it back. You were so nice a second ago.
I wonder if Catrin Allway's healing touch is as soothing as everyone claims. I'd sure love it if she touched me.
Wow. That went from zero to creepy right away. Okay, let's continue on our adventure over here. Where am I going? Over here. I don't even know whether I'm ready to fight these guys yet. But I feel like I want to for the sake of this poor old guy. Am I heading correct direction? Guess we'll find out. Yeah, that's good. Yeah, so a lot of sort of grim and tragic things. Apparently they weren't good to the help, the Crawleys. A lot of people died there. Mrs. Crawley died sort of mourning her husband in this little chapel room that she has, that was sort of on the second floor, but sort of it was separate from the rest of the house. It was sort of like on a balcony sort of thing. And they said that that room was supposedly really haunted. Yeah, and then there's these stables with those old carriages and things, which are quite creepy. It's quite dark in there too. You've got sort of a really weird, creeped out feeling in there, definitely. I did not like being on the second floor of that house. It was just, the kids had died on the second floor of the house. Apparently pregnant women often who toured the house had to leave, or they felt sick in certain rooms on the second floor. So yeah, it was definitely an interesting place. And even weirder, the town, it's a very small town, very small country sort of town, that's, it's like it's almost dedicated to the Crawleys who owned this house that is now known as the most haunted house in Australia. So that's even sort of weirder. Like, there's a museum that was sort of dedicated to Mrs. Crawley's dresses and outfits and things. Mr. Crawley had something to do with the railway station and the trains that were in this town, Junee. Yeah, so they obviously had a big influence. They were a wealthy family. And now the whole town is like a shrine to them, basically. Add that to junk. So when I went there, I actually got to meet the guy that restored the house. Hang on. And he seemed more into it than his wife did. I sort of felt a little bit sorry for his wife. Well, she seemed a bit over it. Like, she said that she didn't like being in the house by herself. And they weren't a young couple, they were a good age. He's since passed away. I was sort of glad that I got the chance to meet him, though, because he was an interesting character. He had lots of stories to tell about the house. Like, before they'd even installed electricity, one night they'd driven home and they saw all the lights on in the house. Yeah, obviously there wasn't electricity, so that's a little weird. Oh, this is new. Okay. I'm not even close to where I'm supposed to be going. I guess I'm winding. Whoa! Hi. I just sort of stood there like, no? Wow, belly flop.
No.
Don't pick on somebody your own. Do pick on somebody your own size. Oh my gosh. Stop beating me up, you. There we go. Naughty night, you. How dare you pick on me. Pick on somebody your own size, you. Yeah, so like I was saying, I kind of felt a little bit sorry for her since she sort of seemed to have been dragged into the whole thing. He had previously been an antique dealer, hence he was able to restore the house to, I don't know, a historically correct degree. He had access to the right sort of antiques, etc. And they rebuilt everything. Almost from scratch, really, because the house was just a burnt-out shell when they got there. Which was even creepier when you see pictures of this old sort of Victorian homestead that was just a burnt-out shell. Yeah, so when we got there, we met him first. I'm not sure when we met his wife. I think we met his wife at the end when we sort of went into their gift shop slash information center, if you will. This corpse contains a mission brief from Shirley. Take the mission brief. Hi, did you see me? Holy crap, what are you doing? Who is he fighting? Okay, I'll help you. Wait, oh, that's my friend. Isn't it?
It's good you're here. I was beginning to think you were just something I saw in the bottle.
Welcome to the ruins of Delok. Lay off the booze, buddy. Why are we here? This is the place. I still think you're crazy.
Because for some reason, you can change fate. In here, I can get a glimpse of the whole of the weave and see where you should fit in.
Yes. It doesn't look like much, but in these ruins lies the Theater of Fate, the ancient home of the Fate Weavers. Come with me. No telling what we'll find down there. It's the ruins of the Theater of Fate. This is where the first Fate Weavers learned how to read the weave. They left their wisdom behind in the Destiny Stone. I'm hoping that the stone will tell me who you are. In we go.
Well, this should be fun. Oh, here we go. Can you stay out of trouble for like 5 seconds, please?
Too late to escape, mate.
Wow, I'm taking them out pretty easily now. Hey, don't pick on my friend. Magic seems to really... Thank you. Wish I could say the same for you, buddy. Okay. I thought I saw something over here. Boiled leather leggings. Compare. Oh, hello. Yeah. Don't. Ah. Stop getting my hopes up. I'll take them anyway. Thank you. Let's go. Yeah, so basically the story is when...
Ever since this place was abandoned, strange beasts have moved in. Stay close.
Ah, waterfall. Ah, waterfalls. So pretty. So pretty. Okay. You want to tell me more about this place, or can I just wander off?
Just a legend.
All right. Love these environments, they're so cool. Hello, big fella. I hope you're the only big fella down there. One of you is enough. Can we sneak past? Oh, you're going to go, aren't you? That's the worst thing about this game. They tend to wander off even when you're hiding.
Alright, let's go. Let's see if we can sneak. I don't know whether we can. I don't think it's going to work. But maybe it will. Who knows?
Hey. Are you talking to me or him? Stop hitting me! Bastard. Wow, he's not even taking a beating over here. Jim, seriously. Ugh, stop belly flopping. Wonder what happens if they kill my fight weaver. Do I get. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hey, buddy. Knock it off there. Did he just restore my health? I think he just restored my health.
Keep quiet. We aren't safe here.
No kidding. Wow. Thank you, Captain Obvious. Wait. Wait a second here. What is this steel hammer you tell me of? Yeah. Although it doesn't have lightning or shocking damage, but still, 53 over, yeah. Don't mind if I do. Birch longbow, you can go the way of the dodo. So can that. I don't even use longbows, I don't even know why I have that. I guess just for emergencies. When I went there, we met him first. He told us a bit about the place. There's sort of like a dance hall behind it where they used to throw balls and stuff in the old days, and they still did at the time when we went there as well. People would get dressed up in Victorian stuff. But the one weird thing that happened to me there, apart from feeling really creeped out on the second floor, first floor I felt a little creeped out, but not half as much. Like the second floor, I just didn't want to be there. That feeling of dread. I'm way too close to this guy. And I'm being attacked by wolves. Where are you? Help me out, please. Die, you. There we go. But the one thing that happened that was weird, when I went to the bathroom, it was off the ballroom. We were the only people there. Me and my partner at the time. I think we went there early, so, you know, other tourists sort of hadn't shown up yet. Also a very quiet town, so I don't imagine that they really get a lot of people through there. At that time of year, auto attempt. I hate those things. I'm not gonna bother. So yeah, it was fairly quiet. There was nobody else around. There was nobody else in the ballroom area, which was quite big. And you would hear people if they came in because it was a wooden floor. It echoed in there. It was so big. Oh. So yeah, I would have heard somebody if they had just walked into the hall that was off the bathroom. But when I went in there and went into the bathroom stall, I heard the bathroom door open, close, and then like I saw a shadow of somebody passing the stall I was in. And you know, I just thought, okay, somebody else must have come through. Somebody else must be using the bathroom. And
well, most of us can.
Okay. And anyway, when I got out of the stall that I was in, there was nobody else there. There was nobody in any of the other stalls next to me. And like, the bathroom door was one of those heavy, squeaky bathroom, public bathroom doors. They're the ones that sort of when you open it and make a heavy sort of sound when it closes. It was one of those. So if the person had left that I saw come in, obviously I would have heard that, but I didn't. And there was literally no one else around. I even sort of like checked the other stalls because I thought, this is weird. I saw a shadow pass the thing, like somebody walked past it, and I heard the door open. And there was only one door out, so that was weird and creepy, and I just wanted to get the heck out of there right away. Yeah, so that was really my only weird experience at Australia's Most Haunted House. Apparently, the ghost needed to use the bathroom. It was definitely weird. I can't explain that one. I mean, there was literally nobody else around. I thought at first maybe it was his wife or something, because we hadn't seen her yet and she would have been the only other person beside him. And obviously, it was a women's bathroom that I was in, because it was for their guests. They had a men's and a women's one. So I assumed that his wife, being the only other woman, would have been the one going in there. Yeah. So I still can't explain that one. Somebody wants to debunk that one for me. Ask me questions about it in the comments. Completely okay with that. Because that still gives me the heebie-jeebies. Because I literally saw a shadow. I didn't see feet. I just saw, like, a shadow pass. Like, somebody was there. Very weird. And I just had this feeling like I just wanted to get the heck out of that bathroom as soon as possible. Because, yeah. When you think somebody else is there and they're not, that's just... a little too creepy. Ain't nobody got time for that. I can tell you a funny sort of not so paranormal story that we thought as kids it was some sort of paranormal experience. When I was about, I want to say 9 or 10, I used to have to go on school camps every, I don't know, I can't remember what time of year it was. I want to say it was maybe October-ish, I want to say, maybe. So the weather is sort of cooling down at that point in Australia. Particularly in Tasmania, where I was living at the time. I don't live there anymore, by the way. Not that that's of any importance. But this camp I used to go to was sort of out in the country. It was on a lake or a river, whatever you want to call it. I think it's more of a lake. I used to catch tadpoles there and all that sort of thing. Very stereotypical sort of camp atmosphere, I guess you could say. Why did they keep doing that to me? Add that to junk. Just going around breaking possibly priceless artifacts over here. Wait a second, is there something here? No? Okay. Anyway, so it was sort of surrounded by the bush.
If only one last time.
What, are you dying? Did you give yourself some sort of liver disease there, buddy? Yours you talk about is drinking. That can't be good. Oh, hey, yeah. Whoa, they have some sort of bomb.
Try this one! But...
I love doing that. So, basically, these camps... Wow. Somebody call an exorcist. What is going on? The power of Christ compels you. Somebody bring me the holy water, please. You coming with, buddy? All right. Don't be drinking back there. So yeah, these camps basically, they had these little competitions, like baking competitions, art competitions. They kept us pretty busy most of the time. Competitions against other schools, basically. Oh, there was a sports day. And then, at different times of the day, well, I should be jumping away here. At different times of the day, we would usually end up getting some free time to ourselves. That'll teach me from looking away from the screen. So yeah, we would end up getting some free time to ourselves. And I don't even think that we were supposed to do this, because generally it's not a good idea to go wandering around the bush anywhere in Australia. Tasmania has brown and black snakes, I believe. Red bellies, actually, which are poisonous. Obviously, it's not the brightest idea to go wandering around by yourself, especially at the age of 9 or 10. But anyway, me and a group of friends, we sort of went into the bush, or the forest, if you will. It's more like sort of bushland. We sort of hovered on the edge. I think we're just wandering around and talking, really, as you do. And we sort of came to the edge of the campsite, and there were just thick bushland, basically. And in one of the trees we could see this red thing, and we saw it move, and I don't know, for some reason we all started to freak out. By the way, this was a religious school that we went to, so... It was sort of... Keep in mind, you're surrounded by kids that have been brought up with... without offending anybody, a lot of superstition, if you will. And since we saw this red thing here in the tree, one of us suggested it could be a demon. And we all sort of freaked out, and one of us, who was a little bit braver, was sort of like, I want to get closer and have a look to make sure of what it was. And so we sort of timidly followed her, all sort of huddled up, if you can imagine this group of about 5 or 6 10-year-old girls timidly walking into the bush towards this tree that had this red thing on it that high up, and we're thinking it's a demon. And then the wind blew it again, and we all sort of screamed and ran because we thought that the demon was moving. Anyway, I think that was later in the day, actually. I think it was just before we were supposed to be going to get dinner at the dinner hall. Pretty sure, because I think it was the next day, we went back to see what it was, because we couldn't stop talking about it, obviously, and we were like, oh, maybe it's not, you know. Oh, one of the girls that was sort of a friend in our group hadn't been there, I think, and she was like, she didn't believe us, and, you know, she thought we were full of it, and she's like, well, show me then, you know, of course. And we were like, okay, but I think somebody suggested we take a Bible or something. It was it was just really funny. And so anyway, of course, we went back, Bible in tow, or friend with Bible in tow, and let me just sort this out. I can't use this, can I? No. Is that what I'm wearing right now? Fate. Okay, let me sell some junk. Whatever is below 7. Just gonna get rid of. Destroy. Yeah. Or 10. I don't need that. Yeah. Ah, yes. Let me see if I can use this again now. Take. Wait, I wanted to equip that. What am I doing with my life? I don't know. Equip. Yeah, see, the cotton robes are no good to me now. Boiled leggings. Yeah. Oh, I can't use them. But I can use those. Cool. All armored up again. Yeah, so we basically went back with this friend and we saw this red thing waving in the wind again. Am I going backwards? I'm going backwards, aren't I? No sense of direction whatsoever. And I think because it was more in the light of day, I think it had been a bit darker. Had been towards sunset, I believe, the last time we'd been out there. We could sort of see what this thing was more clearly. And it turned out to be one of the red jumpers. It was part of our school uniform. Somebody must have chucked it up there or something. But it was just a jumper waving in the wind that we basically thought had been a demon. So, you know, this group of 10-year-old girls had ran screaming from a jumper, convinced it was a demon. If any of those girls ever listen to this, which the likelihood is not very likely, because I don't think I even... Oh, maybe a couple of them I still know. But yeah, that was a funny time. Of course, we all found it very funny after the fact. but the night when we thought we'd seen a demon in a tree, we were all sort of freaked out and we're going to take an adult out there to have the place blessed. Oh, I think one of them started praying, actually, on the night we first went out there. Get rid of the demon. That's very sweet, really. The innocence of youth. I'm not telling this story, by the way, to mock anybody's belief systems or whatever. It was just a funny series of events. So, what is the actual go now? That is the missing charm. Okay, well, I can get that now. I will go get that and then I will finally end this. I'm sorry, I've prattled on for so long.
Once companion to Isak, now enemy to the court. Once lover of Era.
Oh no, I'm not gonna. Oh, you're the one I have to fight. I'm not gonna fight you. No, you're gonna have to. Stop the belly flopping, seriously. Nobody likes you. Oh, good thing I can't fall over this thing. There we go. Wow, magic works so well when that happens. Alright, so let's go. Yeah! Alright, hand over the ring, buddy. Alright. There we go, we've got it now. Alright, where is our friend? Okay. Poor old thing, he just wanted some company. Maybe delusional, but... where are you? Is he over here? My blinders are bad over here. Oh, he's inside. Okay. Where is he? Oh, he must be upstairs asleep. Of course, I always seem to be waking people up, or he's downstairs. Oh, there he is. Not asleep. Okay, good.
You found it after all.
No worries.
For Mulder's sake, I'm glad you didn't leave it with that monster. I have a few coins left to my name, and you can take them. And the bed's free for your use whenever you care for it.
Oh, thank you. I feel bad taking his money, though. Oh. See, this is what I mean about these games. We should be able to give money to whoever we want, and that can change things. I don't know, either for the better or worse. Poor lonely old guy. Anyway, guys, I have rattled on quite enough, I think, for today. And please like if you like the video, and subscribe if you'd like to see more. I do videos every Sunday to Wednesday. And I will see you next time. Thanks for watching, guys. See you later.
Bye, everybody!